wall in front of me. And it's almost as high as my chest. I'll run towards that wall, jump, and dive over it. And that feeling that I enjoy. Good evening, Toastmasters and friends.
Good evening.
I'll climb walls, I'll jump on ledges, I'll jump over those ledges. My environment, my surroundings, it's all my personal playground. Now, I do this because it's fun. It's exhilarating, and when I do it, I feel alive. I feel free as a bird. When I see other people do parkour, they'll run, they'll jump, they'll fly over walls, over roofs. It's just amazing. It mesmerizes me. I envy them because I want to be able to do that as well. See, they just ignore gravity. Gravity calls them and they'll say, no, thank you. But when I see the joy on their faces, when I see that thrill, that exhilaration, that freedom, that's why I do parkour. This is the exact same freedom, the exact same feelings I get when I was a child, just running around, jumping around freely in the playground. I mean, I used to do that so much. I would just love to find obstacles, find walls, and I'll just love to test myself. How far can I jump? How high can I jump? Why? Why would anyone do this? I was just curious. You see, they say curiosity kills the cat, but satisfaction brings it back stronger. Now I remember this one time I tried to run and jump over that wall not too long ago, and I thought I made it. I felt that thrill, I felt that rush, and then my toes clip the wall's edge, and my foot gets caught on the wall. And I fall. I fall hard. My shin bleeding, my shoulder black and blue. And it's when I fall, that's when I hear these voices. Why are you so foolish? Stop being childish. Stop jumping around like a kid. Just be sensible, be responsible, be an adult. Sometimes these are my own voices, voices of doubt. Sometimes they're voices from others. And I don't like these voices. Because when I hear that, those words, it says, stop, just be sensible. To me, that means being sensible is not freely exploring what you can do. Being sensible means to limit yourself. And I don't like that. Now thankfully, the parkour community, the myriad of personalities that we find, they're always encouraging. They are always pushing. They always see the best in you and they want you to succeed. They're the ones who tell me, hey, try again when I fall. You just have to jump a little bit higher, just a little bit further. I'll try again. I'll fall. I'll try again. I'll fall. They'll keep saying, try again. Come on, Hans. I know you can do this. So I try, and eventually, when I do make that jump, high fives all around. That feeling of unity, that feeling of solidarity, I feel like I'm part of a family. And that family shares one common passion. Toastmasters and friends, yeah, parkour, I jump around, I run, I climb. Some part of you tells you really shouldn't do that, but I'll do it anyway. Why? Because it's thrilling, it's fun. But more importantly for me, I explore my own abilities. I explore my own capabilities. I'll see a wall and I'll ask myself, can I go over that wall? How would I jump over that wall? So I'll try. Now I may fall a lot along the way, but that's fine. Each fall makes my drive stronger, pushes me further. Parkour for me is my journey of self-discovery. And the community, the family, strongly backs that vision, and they back me on that journey. Just like our own Toastmasters family here. So, as long as I keep doing parkour, I will keep seeing possibilities within myself, for myself, and I will keep realizing potential. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why I do parkour. Toastmasters of the evening.